Let's say you get this large CSV file and you need to summarize, basically group the cells by state in an Excel table, and then create a filled map chart based on the group results. One minor issue is that state and city are in the same column, so we gotta get them split to separate columns. Now, you don't have much time for this task either. Your boss needs that report right now. What are you gonna do? Let's use Power Query. This is how our CSV file looks. We have invoice line information, we have the description of the product, the customer name, city and state, and the sales information, so the sales value. Now here's our problem, city, state, both of these information is sitting in the same column. This is the one that we need to split. Now it's quite a large CSV file. What we're gonna do first is to create a connection to it from Excel and then see how we can group this data and summarize this information. Okay, so I'm just gonna close this. Let's open up Excel, go to the Data tab. I need to import an external CSV file, so this is from text CSV. That's my file right here, customer sales data, and import. Now Power Query is gonna take a quick look at this and see what the delimiter is. It picked it up correctly, it's a comma. Everything looks quite good here. Let's go to transform and just double check that the change type and everything else is done properly. Now all of this looks good here. The sales numbers, I don't have any decimals in there, they're whole numbers, so I'll just leave it at that. Now for the name, let's call our end result sales by state. Okay, so the only information we need from here is the state and the sales. First off, we need to split the state from the city state column. Here we can use a transformation. Now since I don't need city information, I'm gonna go directly to the transform tab. If I wanted to add a new column for state, I can do that from the add column tab. So under transform, let's go and extract. I just want text between delimiters. Now my delimiter is a bracket, so open bracket, and the end delimiter is a close bracket. So that should extract the state from the city state column, and okay. Let's just rename this to state. Okay, so far so good. Next step is to group this by state, right? So we can use the group by feature, which is also in the transform tab. Select group by. We want to group by state. The new column name is going to be total sales because that's what we want to see in our end report. For the operation, we don't want to count. Instead, I want to get the sum. And the column in question is the sales column. And okay, so now I have summarized my total sales by state. It's like creating a pivot table, but I've done that inside Power Query. All I have to do is send this to the workbook. Let's go to home, close and load two. I'll just put it on this existing worksheet. A1 is fine. And my task is done. Now there is a live connection from this table to the CSV file. So if we get new data or get information on new states, all I have to do is refresh this and we're gonna see it pop up here. But before I do that, I wanna show you how you can create a filled map chart from this information. All I have to do is select this information, then go to Insert, go to Maps, and select Filled Maps. Now, filled maps are available in Excel 2019 and also Excel for Office 365, or actually Excel for Microsoft 365. Now, you get the map here automatically. There's nothing you have to do, you just have to click on it. It figures out the states as long as they're spelled correctly, and it tries to find the right map for it. Now, you have some options that you can do. So if I just double click on any of these or press Control 1 to bring up the options here, notice we have map projection is under automatic, but we can change this. So if I change this to Miller, we get a slightly different map. So let's put this back to automatic. Under map area, we also have the ability to only select regions with data, country region, show the world instead of just the US part. Let me just switch this back to automatic as well. Now under map labels, we can use the best fit only just so that we can see the name of the state in there. As long as our chart is big enough or the state is big enough, we can see that label. Then under series color, we can define what we want to see for the lowest value and the highest value. So the darker a state, the bigger the number. And we have the ability to change these as well. So I could go with a light orange and maybe a dark green. Okay, so that's it. It's so easy to create this. We can also add data labels if you want. So I'm actually going to do that. So let's just go to the plus here. Sometimes it's easier to select. Go to data labels and just activate it. That's it. We can see the labels in there. Now, they are not formatted properly. It's better to have the thousand separator in them. So I'm just going to select this and add the thousand separator, and let's remove the decimal places. Okay, so that was it. All we have to do is give this a title. And we're done. So as a last step though, let's test our connection here. What I want to do is add new information to the CSV file. So let's go and open that CSV file. I'm going to go all the way to the bottom, copy that last one, and use a new state. So instead of Pennsylvania, let's go with Santa Fe in New Mexico. So I'm going to put that in brackets as well. I'm also going to update the number to a big number. Let's go with 10,000. Okay, so let's save this, close and save, and go back to our workbook. Now, when I refresh this, I should see the Santa Fe, basically New Mexico information on here. New Mexico is right here. Currently, I have no sales in that state. Now, when I refresh this, I should. So let's test, right mouse click, refresh. It's grabbing the data and I get my 10,000 in there. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you like what you see on this channel and you wanna expand your skills, consider subscribing. And I'm gonna see you in next week's video.